Our next presenter is Mr. Clark. Mr. Clark has a BSc from UWI and a MSc. He's also the operations manager of the Barbados, Caves of Barbados Limited. Mr. Clark, perhaps, is known to me as the engineer or the technical person on board what was perhaps the first independent photovoltaic system to be connected to the grid as far back as, what was that, 10, 15 years ago? Pardon? 1999. And I was a witness when those panels were going on board, and he'll tell you more about that project and others. So now we'll take this opportunity to ask Mr. Clark to come and make his presentation.
Hello, good morning. Now, my presentation today will be the application of photovoltaic at Harrison's Cave. Now, the reason for photovoltaics, first of all, what I would do it as the operation manager from a maintenance or operation perspective. Now, first of all, I will look at what are the topics that are involved in facilities management, and you will see that those are the ones that I have up on board. Now, secondly, we started our energy conservation way back in 1997, and it was with the braking system. It should be BRAKING but we started with the braking system. It was the regenerative braking system at Harrison's Cave, and that was our first foray into the conservation, energy conservation at Harrison's Cave. Now, you know that Harrison's Cave is a natural attraction. So we, at that time, way back in 1998, we were looking at other things that would complement Harrison's Cave. And we were looking at energy conservation. We were looking also at composting. We're looking at water use, and also the management of wastewater. And so at that point in time, the first thing that we could have done right away would have been to install a photovoltaic system. And that is what was embarked upon. At that point in time, those persons who would have been responsible or involved in the design and the procurement would have been the National Conservation Commission, the Environmental Special Projects Unit, which is now the Natural Heritage Department, and the late Professor Oliver Headley. In fact, Professor Oliver Headley was the one who put us in contact with the person the company who actually did our photovoltaic system. Now, the photovoltaic system, as the partner with BP, we first had to look at the design, we have to look at the installation, and we look at the benefits and the output of the system. The design of the system involved the BP coming to Barbados, looking at our site to see where it could have been installed and what the size of our system would have been. It also involved our people. It was also involved the cost to the procurement and also transfer of technology and the actual operation of the system. Now, after the visit by BP Solar, there was also a visit by a team from Harrison's Cave that went up to BP Solar in Australia to look at the systems that were there. And we were able to see where they had applied the photovoltaic system, and it was at the 2000 Olympic Stadium at Sydney. And you would see that they're at this point installing those. It wasn't fully completed, but they were doing some installations. Also, this is where we had our training on how to do the installation of the system, and that training was done at BP. And then after the training, we had the handing over of the system at that point in time. And if you also notice in this slide, there is a tower. That was one of the lighting towers that was used at the Olympic site, where it collected the solar, and then the lights were lit by that. Then eventually, the system was shipped to Barbados, and you see that it's being received at that. And then after it was shipped, it was unpacked, and then we had to, what you are seeing now would be the structure on which it would have been placed at Harrison's Cape. Now, this site was chosen because of where we are in Harrison's Cape is actually a gully, and the amount of sunlight, direct sunlight that you would get would be very limited, between 10 and 2. So another site had to be chosen. And that site was chosen at the higher level, but there were also some drawbacks at that in that area, because it was only a small system that could have been put on that site, and also we had some problems with the, you know, it's also in a gully area where there are a lot of trees, so that at some point in time shadows would have fallen on the panels, which will then cause a degeneration of the supply of electricity from those solar panels. This is another shot of the installation infrastructure. And here you will see where the installation start was done. This is the inverters on the inside, and what you're seeing is the persons from the Ministry of the Environment who had come to look at what would have been completed. This is another shot of the panels of the inverters. And if you notice that those inverters are pretty large. And now, so since 1999, we have an improvement in the size, which means that they are much smaller to produce the same amount of electricity. Here is a section of the installation being done. And our installation at Harrison's Cape was done solely by the technical department at the cave. So that was another form of technology transfer, and also it was one way of getting those persons who will be dealing with the operations and the maintenance to get involved in actually the setting up of the system. Now, this is what it looked when we had completed all the solar panels. And if you would see the trees, that would have impacted on the output, and also even the electrical lines that pass across, even at that small size, that would have caused a great deal of degeneration in the output of the system. So what it would like to look here at this point are, since we have been since we had that system, it was in production for seven years, and we had an output of over 88,000 kilowatt hours from that system. And coming out of what we would have gone through with the maintenance and also the operations of that system, the emerging issues that came out would have been the continuous training and development of staff, keeping people informed of the new as the technology improved, and also any new equipment that would have come up. Another issue that we would have found out was that the availability of parts. At that point in time, we only had one supplier, which was in Australia, and it was quite a challenge getting things in timely fashion. Now, another set of the issues would be protection against hurricanes. What would we do with the panels during the hurricanes? Would we take them down, or would we have sufficient insurance that we can leave them up, and if anything is damaged, we can come back? So those are things that we would have to look at, and also the integration of the solar panels into the building fabric. Now, what we have to do at this point in time is that you put on your roof and then you add on to that. Now, one of the good things would be if we can use the solar panels as part of the structure of the roof. And another emerging issue was the initial startup cost of the project. And you may ask, how was the size of the system chosen? It was chosen due to budget and also to the space that was available for the installation of the panels. And also the other drawback from where it was sited was that it was away about 600 feet away from the energy center, which would have mean that there would be a loss in power traveling from the generation of the solar voltage to the energy center. At that point, we when Harrison Scape was redeveloped, a decision was taken that the site where we will be putting the car park would then house the new panels, such that you have a more direct supply of the electricity. You will have no interference from trees, and also the area can be used, the panels can be used as shade for vehicles, which would mean that those owners of those vehicles would be saving energy by having to use a small amount of the air conditioning power. Now, the new system, we now have the new system being put in place, and you will see the photographs where you have the structure that is being built, the areas where the inverters will be placed, and you see that there are two sets of inverters, and also a completed area fully covered of the car park. This is another area that is covered over the tram storage building. That is where the maintenance of the tram vehicles are placed. And what in this redevelopment, this presentation this installation of the photovoltaic system is that it is such that we can improve on it. Our percentage output from that system is about 35 to 40% of our use. Where the previous one that was done over 12 years ago would have been 10%, average of 10% of our use. Now, you know that our usage would have gone up, and even although we have gone up higher with, instead of a 17 kilowatt supply, we have gone up now to a 60 kilowatt supply, but the amount of savings, or let's say of production of energy, is only 35 to 40. And I think that budget is has caused an impact on that, because after our first system, it was thought that we should go to 100% solar voltaic supply of power for our use, because you know that our cave, as I said, is natural. It is such that it's a natural environment, it's still growing, so we do not want anything to be taken into the cave that would impact on the growth of the formations. So, you know, only electrical powered vehicles are used inside the cave. And we also did, in order for protection of the formation, we use soft lighting, which is some LED lighting, and also we are making sure that the light turn off automatically after you have passed the area that is being viewed, which would reduce any lamp and floor that is formed on the formation. So that is, we might say, that's another area of in which we are looking at energy conservation at Harrison Scale.